So I literally called this bitch. I'm like, Danielle, come to my room. She's like, what happened? Come to my room. And I show her. She's like, oh my God, you took your hair out? I said, it was too tight. Just like I told you. She's like, yeah, it wasn't even that serious. I was like, look in the middle of my head. She's like, oh, is that a bald spot? It's a cave, bitch. Yes, it's a fucking bald spot. And she's like, oh my God, girl, I'm so sorry. I didn't even know it was that tight. Are you on fucking drugs? Like, I told you mad times that the shit was tight. You said, shut the fuck up. I was so upset because I had gone so far in my natural hair journey. I can't wear my afro out like that because now I got a fucking bald spot in the middle of my head, okay? This is unacceptable. Like, I'm so upset. She's apologetic or whatever. She should've given me my goddamn money back. I should've took her ass to fucking Judge Mathis some shit because Now I'm walking around looking, okay, I'm not gonna say half bald. That's a little extra, but like, now I got a bald spot in my head. Like, what kind of bullshit is this? My channel. Welcome to another installment of 12 Days of Storytime. I hope everyone is enjoying the new year. My birthday is on Wednesday, so y'all already know I'm up. I'm happy, happy, dappy. If your birthday is January 5th, comment down below because you are my birthday twin. If you're a Capricorn, comment down below because it's a national motherfucking holiday month situation. It should be on a goddamn calendar. We start and end every month. Capricorn season, what you talk about. But anyhow, today we're going to be talking about my worst natural hair experiences. I feel like I have a couple, but we're gonna be telling a collection of small ones, okay? Now, understand, when it comes to having natural hair, it's very, very different, okay? When your hair is not relaxed, when it's not texturized, when you don't got a keratin treatment, whatever, completely different ballgame, especially when you are a black woman's, right? So first things first, I was natural up until I think I was like 11 or 12. I think I've told this story on this channel before. Essentially, my godmother put relaxed in my hair without my mom knowing, and she was genuinely upset, but I was a happy bitch because, you know, I looked like the other girls. It was never one of those things where I didn't like my hair or I hated my hair. It was just one of those things where I just wanted to be like everyone else. Everyone else had, like, you know, straight hair and was looking cute, so I was like, oh my God, I want to look like them too. It was never like I hate my hair texture, I hate how my mom has to, like, you know, do all of this shit. It was never like that. It was just like I want to be like the other girls, which I feel like a lot of kids have that initial feeling and want to be like their other peers. So before that, my mom would always hot comb my hair. And I already know everyone, every black girl watching this has that memory of getting their hair hot combed, the shit on the stove. We're not talking about no electric hot comb. That shit, it didn't give you the same results, okay? You can use that for your wig, but on natural hair, like virgin natural hair at that, you gotta use the one on this stove. And my mom, she didn't do this often. I feel like she would only hot comb my hair maybe once every couple of months for like either a special occasion or if she wanted to do a specific type of style on my hair. And at this time, I was having that moment where it's like, I wanna do my own hair. I wanna have this type of hairstyle. I want my hair to be down. Like, so, you know, she went, she hot combed my hair, and she burned the whole back of my neck because I kept moving and I had an attitude. Completely my fault. You know, the thing is with Haitian people, no remorse. They don't care about your feelings, okay? My mom's sitting there screaming at me because she burned me with the goddamn hot comb. And I'm mad, even though I know I'm moving around, I know I got an attitude. I'm just like, bruh, you supposed to be a little bit more passionate. Now I got a patch the size of motherfucking Texas on the back of my neck. I'm burning and it's itchy because, you know, after you get a burn, it starts to itch after a while. And like, I'm so mad because, like, I wanted the hair, but like, my mom didn't even like leave it out straight, honestly. Like, she literally hot combed it and then proceeded to like style it in rubber bands. Like, that was like my go-to style as a kid. Like, my mom always like did my hair with rubber bands and then she would twist them. It always looked pretty. I really liked it, but at the same time, every time she would hot comb it, I would hope she would just like let me leave it out or put it in a little ponytail. But she's like, oh no, that's too grown. And this is how I feel. I don't think there's anything grown about straight hair. Like, I don't think it's that fucking serious. You know, that's the old school mentality. I feel like even now there's a lot of people that still feel that way. I think it's just absolute nonsense. If a kid wants to wear their hair certain way, I believe they should be able to, as long as it's not like additives. Like, I don't think people should be putting weave in a kid's hair because it's just too much to maintain. But anyhow, my mom never let me do my own hair, so, you know, I used to be mad, annoyed, or whatever. And, you know, the hot comb situation had to be one of the worst things when it came to having natural hair. And the thing is, I have hair that doesn't like to cooperate with anything, which is probably why getting locks was like the most like best decision for me. And even at that, I didn't even want to cooperate with the locks. Like, I'm very sure it took like at least maybe a year for my hair to fully lock, like, and get it to actually look like locks. Because there were times I had to go get multiple retwists because my hair would just like be like, nope, bitch, revert. Like, that's just how my hair is set up. So my mom would literally be sitting there hot combing my hair and it still wouldn't be straight. It would just be like a stretch straight. And y'all know how hot a hot comb is and it still wouldn't be straight. So it's just, that just tells you how non-cooperative my hair is. So moving on, when I was about, no, I was 18 because I was about to go to college. My family and I went on a family vacation. I already told this story a couple times on my channel, and I had full locks in my hair, but I was kind of transitioning. So half my hair was natural, half of it was straight. So my hair was long as shit. So I could say about like up to here was natural and up to here was straight. And that shit looked horrible because, like, oh my God, y'all already know. If you know, you know. When you're transitioning, it just looks stupid. You have like two hair textures and then you have all of your other natural hair textures just all over the place. So when I took my full locks out, mind you, we went on family vacation. So we went to the beach. We did all this goofy shit, sweat, sand, everything got in my hair. So I'm trying to take my full locks out and everything is getting stuck. It's like I would unravel it. The natural part would come out fine. And then as soon as it got to the part that was still relaxed, my hair said, nope, bitch, nope. And we get tangled, it's getting stuck, it's hurting like hell. It took me at least 6 hours to get my full locks out of my hair. And at the time, my little cousin was natural, not by choice. Like, her mom, which is also my godmom, ended up chopping all her hair off because she said it was damaged. I don't even remember what her hair looked like before that, but I really don't think it was that serious. So basically, she shaved her hair bald. And understand, my cousin actually goes to a predominantly white school. She lives in a predominantly white area. And you know, kids can be very ignorant, especially white kids who have not been exposed to black culture or textured hair are extremely ignorant. Comment down below if you know you can relate to this. So basically, they would look at her and they would be like, ew, like, what happened? Do you have cancer? Where's your hair? Like, you know how that goes. Like, you come in with braids, they're confused. You come in with straight hair, they're confused. And then you come in with like something completely different, like some Bantu knots. They just looking at you like, oh my God, how are you able to metamorphose like this? Are you a Power Ranger? Like, they're mad ignorant. And that's what would happen to her. And she started feeling really, really bad. Basically, I'm having my hair problems. And she's like, oh my God, your hair's so long. Basically ignoring the fact that my hair is getting stuck in fucking full locks right now. I'm like, I don't care about my hair being long. I care about my hair being saved because this shit's not coming out. So it's coming out, it's coming out. I'm trying, like, I'm getting combs, I'm getting all types of shit to get it out. Eventually I get everything out of my hair and I'm just like, this shit looks a hot ass mess. Because again, half relaxed, half natural. So I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna chop it off. And she's like, what? Don't do that. Oh my God. And this is the thing, when you're a girl, especially a little girl, like, your worth, your beauty, your confidence is locked in your hair. A lot of women feel like this in general too. Personally, it took me a while to understand that hair is not that serious because it grows back. Like, unless you have a problem or some sort of deficiency, I don't think it's that serious. So I was like, you know what? I'm tired of you complaining about your hair and I'm tired of holding on to my hair because it's long. I'm gonna do a big chop. Girl, when I'm telling you, my cousin cried as if it was her hair being chopped off again. Oh my God, no! Sometimes I'll be thinking like, yo, I was so nonchalant. Like, I'm still nonchalant, but back then, like, I really didn't think about half the things I did. So I was like, snip, snip, ho, ain't nothing, cut that bitch, y'all. So, and mind you, this is right before college. I wanted to get another set of full locks before I got into college, but I was like, you know what, I'm gonna cut my hair first, then go get my hair done. Y'all, I cut my whole hair off. I had a nice little TWA. It was so fucking cute. And my cousin was like, she was shocked that I really sat there and cut my hair. And the main reason I did it, besides the fact that my hair was damaged, was because she did not feel confident in herself. And I hated that. I hated that she did not love herself because her mom chopped her hair off. I hated that kids were making fun of her. I hated all that. So I was like, you know what? Since you're so, you know, hell bent on thinking that you're ugly without your hair, I'm gonna show you right now. We both gonna be bald headed. We both gonna be bad bitches and be that set. Cut my hair off. Everything was good. But I ain't gonna lie. I was sitting there like, oh hell no, I'm about to go get my full locks, bitch. And I went to the airport. There was some lady that was sitting there like, oh my God, your hair is so beautiful. And I'm like, really? It was on some little old white lady. And I was in the airport. Like, I kid you not, I had my hoodie on, shit like tight. Cause like the hood had flew off or whatever. And I'm like, really? And after that, you know, I started getting compliments. And I'm like, really? Sometimes it takes other people, especially when you're younger, to say something to you for you to actually realize what you truly are, who you truly are, what you truly look like. So I was like, you know what? think I can rock this. I think I could do this little natural thing. You know, I could do this shit. So I went to college with my natural hair. Okay, I rocked my natural hair every single day in an afro. I would literally wash it a lot. And I'm not even gonna lie, I don't know what it is. My hair does so much better with lots of water or just by leaving it alone. If I do these regular regimens of like list outs and moisturize oil, my hair will not grow. If I leave it completely alone and don't touch it, it does 10 times better. Or if I literally wet it consistently, it does better. I don't know what it is, but I literally would wash my hair every day, every other day, and I would blow dry it into an afro. No, my hair was never damaged. I never had heat damage. I never had anything. That's what I would do. It was so fucking cute. I was a baddie bitch. I was, loved it. So I really, you know, went to college and that was my staple look. The girl with the heels and the girls with the afro, okay? It was kind of like a self-love journey that I didn't intentionally want to do in the first place. I just ended up doing it and I fell in love with myself. I fell in love with my hair. And I already, you know, spoke about this before, but of course I was met with lots of criticism. My mom would talk shit about my hair. I had dudes that I would talk to that would talk shit about my hair. Like, oh, your hair looks better straight. Like, why would you do that? Like, you should put a weave in. You should get some braids. And I'm like, you should mind your fucking business. You should wash your dick. Let me stop. That's not nice. But anyways, now we're moving into my first, well, technically second story, because I already told you guys about the, you know, hot comb shit. So now we're moving into my second story. Now, I don't know what it is. Comment down below if you agree. As soon as I went natural, my scalp became ridiculously sensitive. I spent I would say a long time, like maybe 7 or 8 months, nothing in my hair whatsoever. Not a weave, not a sew-in, not braids, nothing. I didn't put shit in my hair. I just let it grow. I, you know, would blow dry it into my little afro, left it at that. Never had any issues. So now I decided to get a sew-in because I remember, okay, when my hair was completely, you know, transitioning, or when I had relaxed hair, my hair would always grow a lot better in sew-ins. And I had a spring formal that was coming up. Bloomfield always had a spring formal. It was usually pretty lit, and this one was on a yacht. So y'all know, bitch, I was not missing no yacht formal. And I was like, you know what? Everybody sees me my afro all day. Let's try to switch it up, okay? A lot of people have this common misconception that black girls hate their hair and they don't ever want to wear their hair. To be honest, there's a lot of girls that are like that. I'm gonna just say that right now. There's a lot of girls that don't have the confidence to rock their hair yet, and it is what it is. And I feel like that is a problem. If you're one of those people that really can't walk out with your natural face, with your natural hair, you got some work to do. A lot of people like to say that, and a lot of people were like, oh my god, why don't you just go with your afro? I'm like, nah, I kind of want to do something different. And my afro does not do well in humidity. It was kind of hot at the time, so I was like, yeah, I'm gonna just braid it up. And you know, I haven't had a sew-in in a long time. So I had a friend, and we're gonna call her, you know, I actually mentioned her in another story time, but I don't even remember what I called her. What the fuck did I call her? Danielle. There you go. So we had Danielle, right? Me and Michelle would always hang out, but eventually Michelle did not fuck with Danielle. I still don't remember why. I'm gonna have to ask Michelle, like, why didn't you like her again? And Danielle did hair, and she did hair pretty damn well. I asked her to do a sew-in for me with like a bang. It was like a red hair situation with a bang. I might put the picture here if I could find it, but the picture's so old, and I know I don't have it on my phone because, like, that is literally old iCloud, old phone, old all that. And you know, she's sitting there, she's doing my hair, she starts braiding, and it's tight, but it's not like unbearable, but I've never felt any pain while getting my hair braided ever in my life until this time. But mind you, I haven't had anything in my hair for like a long ass time, and even before that I had full locks for a long time. So like, it had to be over a year since I had anything, so like regarding like a sew-in or anything like that. So she starts braiding my hair. It feels a little tight, and I tell her, see, this is not gonna be one of them story times where I'm like, oh well, I was scared, oh I didn't say anything. I'm the type of bitch, I always say when I feel uncomfortable, I always say when I don't like something. So I'm telling her, like, yo, like, it's a little tight. She's like, ah, you just tend a headache. Don't be telling me that the way I feel is completely different from the way I feel, because I'm telling you how the fuck I feel. That shit is the surefire way to get you cussed out, okay? So I'm just like, I ain't say nothing to her. I'm just like, okay, I'm telling you it's tight. She's like, no girl, I'm not even doing your hair that tight. I was like, all right, that's two strikes for you, bitch. You know what? I'm gonna just let you finish. Let me just see. Maybe it's just me. But I'm telling y'all, it started to hurt. Like a sting type of hurt. And I'm like, all right, Ivana, relax. Y'all, this girl proceeds with the thread now. Cause you know, most of the time, you know, you have to thread the like little ends of the hair or whatever. When I'm telling y'all, caliente, shit was hot. I was in so much pain just from the thread. Because yes, the braids were tight, but the thread made it worse. Because at that point, you're pulling all the braids together to make a cohesive type of thread, so you're able to sew it in. And at this point, I'm like, nah, Danielle, this shit hurt. Like, this shit hurt like hell. Like, girl, like, damn, like, you talking too much. Like, you doing too much. Like, it's not even that tight. Like, it's not even that tight. You tell me this shit not even that tight one more time, I'm gonna be tight. I've never felt this type of pain. So I'm just thinking, okay, maybe it's because I haven't had my hair done in a while. Maybe it's because I just became natural. Comment down below if you guys have had a similar experience, because I don't know what it was. Ever since then, anytime I would get like a sewing or stuff, it would hurt more than usual, but not as bad as this. This shit was so bad. So she's sitting there. Now she starts sewing on the track. I don't know what's worse than worse, but it was worse, y'all. Like, I'm just feeling it and I'm just like, I'm literally holding myself like this. And she's just like, girl, like, you're doing too much. Like, it's not even that tight. And she's laughing, she's making jokes about it. And I'm like, I don't see anything funny about this. I'm literally in pain. So can you please just hurry up? Like, it really, really hurts. She's like, girl, like, you know, she's just dismissing how I feel. My hair looked good. I liked it. Gave her the money. I couldn't even lay on my head. I couldn't focus. I literally skipped class the next day. Formal happened the day after that. So I believe it was 2 days before formal when I got my hair done. So after that was formal. So I probably got my hair done on a Wednesday. Formal was like on a Friday or something like that. And y'all, I could barely enjoy formal because my hair was so fucking tight to the point where like you can see my scalp. My hair is like raised. Like, you know when your hair is so tight, like your scalp starts to raise. And I'm just like, yo, like, there's no way I'm in this much pain. Like, I could not sleep. Michelle is just like, is it really that tight? And I'm like, if somebody fucking asks me one more fucking time if my hair is that tight, I'm literally gonna pop the fuck off, bro. Like, yes, it's that fucking tight. I've never been tender headed, ever. So for somebody to be trying to tell me, oh, your hair is not that tight, bitch, yes, it is. So at this point, after like 3 days of having the sewing in, I started to take it out. Literally, I cut the whole thing out. I unbraided it. My hair was so damaged. And I had a bald spot. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I had a bald spot. What did I say? I used to wear my hair in a stretched afro. Stretched afros don't look good with a fucking bald spot. And the bald spot was like the size, like it was like this big. Okay, it was like this big in the middle of my head, like right over here. And I know exactly where it was because to this day, this part of my head always itches and always feels the most pain when I get a retwist, when I get locks, like when I was getting full locks again, when I had any hairstyle I would get, that part of my head would hurt so bad. And to this day, it still hurts. So I literally called this bitch. I'm like, Danielle, come to my room. She's like, what happened? Come to my room. And I show her. She's like, oh my God, you took your hair out? I said, it was too tight. Just like I told you. She's like, yeah, it wasn't even that serious. I was like, look in the middle of my head. She's like, oh, I had a bald spot? It's a cave, bitch. Yes, it's a fucking bald spot. And she's like, oh my God, girl, I'm so sorry. I didn't even know it was that tight. Are you on fucking drugs? Like, I told you mad times that this shit was tight. Shut the fuck up. I was so upset because I had gone so far in my natural hair journey. I can't wear my afro out like that because now I got a fucking bald spot in the middle of my head. Okay? This is unacceptable. Like, I'm so upset. She's apologetic or whatever. She should have given me my goddamn money back. I should have took her ass to fucking Judge Mathis some shit because Now I'm walking around looking. Okay, I'm not gonna say half bald. That's a little extra. But like, now I got a bald spot in my head. Like, what kind of bullshit is this? So I literally, yo, I'm not even gonna tell y'all, it took me like a year and a half to grow that hair back in the middle of my head. I'm not joking. I had to put so much Haitian castor oil, God bless Haitian castor oil, in my hair in order for that bald spot to grow back. And like I said, to this day, it's still ultra sensitive. It's always itchy no matter what I do. I don't know what can stop this from happening. Comment down below if you guys had a similar experience and you know a product that can make this shit stop itching, because like, it always itches no matter what. Like, I don't get it. I've had so many stylists look at it, so many, like, I have my doctor look at it, like, do you see anything? And they're like, no, there's nothing there. And I'm like, bro, like, this shit is always so fucking uncomfortable. So honestly, be very, very careful who you go to do your hair. Be very, very careful who you trust to do your hair, because people just ain't shit, and people will do things or say things and make it seem like you're invalidated because of how you feel, or you know, just because like you don't have an experience with doing something yourself, they try to like discredit how you feel and stuff. Don't let anyone tell you that. If something is too tight or whatever, not only say it, but actually get your ass up at that chair. And I know you guys are probably like, what? Okay, listen, as you guys can hear from my story, clearly telling her, she didn't give a fuck. I should have hopped out that motherfucking chair and said, fuck it, I'll just wear something else in my hair, because that situation was ridiculous. And now I'm 26. I had to be like maybe 18, 19 at the time, and I still yo, I still feel little bit itch right here. Like, I kid y'all not. Like, it's always so fucking uncomfortable and it's sometimes sore. You do not want to go through that. And I know there's like a lot of other people that get experiences where like their whole, like, you know, front of their hair is gone, all the edges gone. You do not want to go through that, okay? It's a horrible experience. And some hairstylists are just ridiculously inconsiderate and very, very shiesty. And that brings me to this next story, which happened way before all of this, okay? This happened probably when I was like getting my first communion. I don't remember how old I was. I know I was a little older than most people when they get their first communion, so I had to be like 10, 11. I don't remember. I know I got a relaxer when I was about like 12-ish. I don't even know, like, all of these dates are kind of like fluctuating, so please don't quote me on it. But when I was getting my first communion, my mom decided she was gonna take me to the hair salon because, you know, if you guys do not know, if you Catholic or you Haitian, getting your first communion is like fucking getting married, okay? Like, I don't know what it is. They take this shit real, real serious. Whatever. My mom wanted to make sure I was the best looking little girl in this shit because my mom's extra, just like me. And to this day, that's why I'm always dressed all the time. That's why I always make sure I look my best because that's how my parents raised me. I'm going to the damn supermarket. My parents got like a frilly little dress on me, look like I'm going to Sunday church. That's how my parents are. So they made sure when my first communion was coming, oh, it was coming, bitch. So I remember my dress. I loved that dress so much. It was a gorgeous dress. Oh man, I don't think I could ever find a picture of my communion because it's probably somewhere in my parents' house and I'm sure she don't know where the damn pictures are. I literally had this dress that was like a train. Yes, I had a train on my communion dress. Like, I'm telling you, I could have been getting married, okay? The dress was like long sleeve, it had lace, like it was gorgeous. Like, I still low-key want that dress. But you already know Haitians ain't shit and they love to send their goddamn clothes to Haiti, including their kids' clothes without their fucking permission. Yeah, I didn't pay for it, but it was mine. I'm tired of y'all. Haitian parents, if you're watching this, please stop sending your kids shit to Haiti without fucking telling them. Like, it's very rude, it's very disrespectful. I don't like that. So first communion, I went to go get my hair done and, you know, hot comb. Didn't have a relaxer at the time. My mom wanted me to have a half up, half down hairstyle. Now, see, back in that day, people weren't doing half up, half down like that. You know, like, I ain't gonna say I started this shit. Of course not. People were doing it, but it wasn't as popular. So I was really looking like a new bitch, okay? Like, oh my God, I love it. If I could find that damn picture, that would be great. But, you know, it was like a half up, half down. So literally, my hair was up in the front, and then it would have a track at the top and it would be like a wave curl, not like a spiral curl, but like a wave curl. And then the back was also, you know, going to be hot comb, but it was going to be tracks in between, glued in. Let me just say, I do not like that salon that my mom used to bring me to. It was actually a Haitian salon. Anyone that lives in Elizabeth that's around my age will remember this salon because it was the Haitian salon. There was no other Haitian owned salons at that time, and they did everybody's hair, like everybody's hair, whether it was natural, relaxed, whatever. But let me just say, they had no business doing natural hair because every single time I went through with my natural fucking hair, it was a fucking problem. So my mom brings me there, she tells them the style, and she leaves me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't give a fuck how much you trust your stylist. If you're gonna bring your kid somewhere, don't ever leave your kid by themselves. Don't ever trust these stylists not to do no sexy shit. Sit and watch what the fuck they do to your kid's hair. The lady hot combed my hair and she proceeds to cut it. Maybe I had split ends, but she didn't give me a little trim. She cut it. Now that's the thing, when I was younger, my hair was shitting. Like, I had very, very nice, long, voluptuous, thick ass hair. Every time I would go to the salon, every time I would go to the stylist, they would be like, oh my God, you have so much hair. Kind of annoyed because they're like, oh my God, this is way more work. But sometimes it would kind of be like a source of like envy, like, you have so much hair. Like, oh, how'd you do that? Like, what did you do? What did you, like, and the whole time, that's what the stylist was doing. Oh, you have so much hair, we don't do shit there. Like, oh my God, oh la la. And she would like, she kept like stretching it to like see the length, and then like she would talk to the other people around. And the thing is, I really hate when Haitians do this where they think that like just because someone's a kid or someone's younger, they can't understand Creole fully, or just because I was born in America, I can't understand Creole fully. If anything, my Creole was way more better as a kid than it is now. Like, I used to speak Creole like a motherfucking rat. So they just assumed I didn't understand what the fuck they were saying. But the lady the whole time, she's like, oh my God, this is so much hair, I should cut it so, you know, I could get through this faster. But she said it in Creole. And I'm just like, I will fuck you up, bitch. Like, in my head, I'm like, and at the time, I was violent. I always used to choose violence first. So I really probably would have popped in the face and apologized later, probably not. Like, I was very, like, lethal back then. So I'm just looking at her and I'm hearing her. And I responded to her and her. I'm like, no, you won't. Like, no, Paco Bitch should have been messy. And she's like, oh, good boy, my Shelly. Yeah, you understand me, baby? What's funny about that? And she's like, okay, Sherry, do them pop coupon. Lady proceeds to do the top part, everything's fine. So she did the top ponytail. Lady proceeds to the bottom part, and I start hearing scissors. And I'm just like, I'm moving my, I'm like, and she's like, oh, no, Sherry, I'm just dusting. seeing. I'm just doing a little twin.
Now, y'all already know Haitians have a very strict respect your elders nonsense, and I'm trying to respect my elders, but my elder is doing what I clearly told her not to fucking do. So, you know, I stay quiet because I don't want no one to call me Fuiko, Malidver, all those other terms that they deem, you know, Haitian kids to be unworthy, horrible, hectic human beings. So I'm just sitting there like trying to like see, because she flipped me in a way where I can't see the mirrors. Imagine that's the mirror. I'm faced here, like to the back of the salon, and she's cutting me right here. And she's just cutting, and I'm hearing scissors. And now she glues the tracks in, and she's still cutting. And I'm like, okay, now the tracks were pretty long. They were like down here. My mom said that she wanted it to be like up here. So she wanted a good amount of it cut off. And when she put the track in, let me just say, I understand she has to cut the track, but she was not cutting the track. Whatever, my hair was beautiful. It was lit. I loved it. I was so happy with it. I'm living la vida loca. I don't know how to act, okay? I'm flipping that shit. I'm acting like I'm the shit. My mom loved it. Everything was all great and dandy. But you guys already know, like I said, my hair does not like to cooperate. So it started to puff up within like maybe 4 days, okay? That was the straightest I ever seen my hair get, but it puffed up within a couple of days. You know, it was short-lived. And when my hair started to puff up, my mom was looking at my hair like, why does your hair look shorter in the back? Because like I said, the back was out. So it was like hair, track, hair, track, hair. I don't know, ask your fucking friends at the goddamn salon. Because I didn't even tell her about the experience, because the thing is, you already know, when you're a kid, Haitians don't really be trying to pay you no mind. They just think you're trying to be rude or whatever. So I ain't never say nothing. So now, that's when I started telling her the story. Like, yeah, so whatever was cutting my hair, I tried to tell her she shouldn't be cutting my hair because nobody told you to cut my hair. Probably look shorter because she cut it. She's like, what the? What? Hold up. We started taking the tracks out. Impossible. She literally glued the tracks on my hair. Now, that's the thing, right? If you never used to get your hair done like this back in the day, you really wouldn't know. Hair glue was something very, very tricky and could fuck your hair up if you did not do it right. You know, we used to have quick weaves. We used to have like things where, you know, again, people would put like track hair, whatever the case may be. And the thing is, hair glue is something that will take your hair out. Why the fuck did this bitch go and glue the tracks onto my hair that she already cut? So literally it was like hair, and then the track was literally on a little bit of the hair. It was like maybe like half an inch, and then she would glue the track on the hair. And this wasn't all of them, it was maybe like two. I probably had like four or five tracks, maybe about like two to three of them had tracks where it was placed directly on my hair. When you glue tracks, from what I know, because I'm not a stylist, but when I used to do it, when other people would do it for me, they would just glue it on the scalp, not the hair itself. Because clearly, if you put it on the hair itself, when you try to take it out, more than likely, it's gonna come off with your hair. And when you're taking out the track, usually you would have to use like hairspray or hair oil, and usually would just come right out. Because this is not my first time doing this. I've done it after that, and I never had any issues. Boy, nope, my hair started coming out with the track. My hair's already cut. My mom is lit. But you know, this is the thing. My mom be acting like she's tough, but she ain't tough. She ain't about that life, okay? I'm gonna tell you this right now. All she do is talk. All she do is rant. All she do is rah, 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 rah. Like, woo, woo. Every time my mom start yelling, me and my dad, we just be sitting there like, oh my God, here she go again. She ain't about to do nothing. Like, it sounds bad, but it's true. She didn't say nothing to these ladies at the salon. She didn't call them. She didn't complain. She didn't ask for a refund, nothing. I'm just like, I was mad because I'm like, I wanted her to do something about it. But she just sat there and proceeded to complain and get mad that literally half my hair was gone. It grew back within a couple of months though. Like honestly, my hair used to grow like a weed back then. But it was just like very annoying and a very inconvenient experience because you do not expect stylists to do what you did not ask them to do. Especially when they do shiesty shit like putting glue on your hair when they know damn well that's gonna make your hair fall the fuck out. Yeah, that's that story. Let me know down below if you have any similar experiences. I'd love to hear them because I already know my comment section is going to be full of them. I'm sure I have other natural hair stories, but of course, we'll probably save that for another video. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Peep the description box for all the information that you guys always ask me about down below. And I'm going to see y'all next time. Bye!